My name is Kate Egan. I'm a soprano, and I have performed many roles with the Anchorage Opera. I have much to thank them for. 24 years ago this February, General Director Peter Brown and Maestro Stephen Sulich brought me here to sing the role of Eurydice in Offenbach's Orpheus in the Underworld. I fell in love with Alaska. I fell in love with my castmates. And I fell in love with the son of my hostess. My hostess was Marty Quimby, great lady, and I have an incredible husband, John Quimby. I owe him a lot of thank yous too. So I have been very lucky throughout the years. The Anchorage Opera has just treated me so well. And my roles have begun to morph into other things. One of my roles is being a subscriber to the Anchorage Opera. I've been a subscriber for at least 23 years, and I intend to continue until I'm in the grave. Another one of my roles is I am a voice teacher in Anchorage, and I am lucky to have many students in my studio who also sing for the opera. They sing in the chorus, they do roles, and I have to admit that when I go to the opera nowadays, I am usually looking at the chorus to see my people and to support them, which is not to say that I don't enjoy the incredible singers that Reed and Judy bring in. So I would love you to take an opportunity before the end of the year to show your love for Anchorage Opera. I am going to show my love in writing them a big check when I am done with this. And then there's one other thing. I had the opportunity earlier this year to perform with one of my students, who is also a dear friend and a colleague, Don Andres. And so we had prepared a little snippet from the Mikado together, and I hope you will enjoy that. Thank you. Thank you, Reed and Judy. Thank you, John Quimby. Thank you, Anchorage Opera. And thank you to all the wonderful people who have sat in the seats at the Discovery Theater and cheered us on over the years. We couldn't do this without you. Thank you.
There is beauty in the bellow of the blast. There is grandeur in the growling of the gale. There is bellicose outpouring when the lion is a-roaring and the tiger is a-lashing of his tail.
Yes, I like to see a tiger from the Congo or the Niger, and especially when lashing of his tail.
Volcanoes have a splendor that is grim, and earthquakes only terrify the dunks. But to him who's scientific, there is nothing that's terrific in the falling of a flight of thunderbolts.
Yes, in spite of all my meekness, if I have a little weakness, it's a passion for a flight of thunderbolts. If that is so sing, dem, 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 is heaven and fairy, our tastes are one. Away we'll go, and merrily, merrily, nor parley, tarry till day is done. There is beauty in extreme old age. Do you fancy you are elderly enough? Information I'm requesting on a subject interesting is a maiden all the better when she's tough.
Through all this wide dominion, it's a general opinion that she'll last a good deal longer if she's tough.
Are you old enough to marry, do you think? Won't you wait until you're 80 in the shade? There's a fascination frantic and a ruin that's romantic. Do you think you are sufficiently decayed?
To the matter that you mention, I have given some attention, and I think I am sufficiently decayed.
If that is so, sing deri-da-deri, it's evident very our tastes are one. Away we'll go, and merrily, merrily, nor toddly, tarry till day is done. If that is so, sing deri-da-deri, it's evident very our tastes are one. Away we'll go, and merrily, merrily, nor toddly, tarry till day is done. Sing deri-da-deri, we'll merrily, merrily, nor toddly, tarry till day is done.
Done.